Ollie's nightclub is attached to the Merchant Hotel in Belfast Cathedral Quarter. This is where the complainant went on the night of June 27, 2016, after having 1.5 large glasses of wine at a friend's house to celebrate the end of her exams. After leaving the club, she said she got chatting to some girls who were mutual friends of another two friends of hers. She told the trial they invited her back to an after party. She said Paddy Jackson was behind the girls, but she didn't realise it was his house they were going to. She said she ended up sharing a taxi with him and two of the other girls. Paddy Jackson lives in a townhouse in a cul-de-sac in Oakley Park on the south side of Belfast City. This is where the alleged attack is said to have taken place. The complainant went back there for an after party with all of the defendants and three other girls she knew through some mutual friends. She claims she was raped by Mr. Jackson in his upstairs bedroom before Stuart Olding walked in and forced her to perform oral sex on him. She also claims Blaine McElroy walked in at one point completely naked. The four defendants each gave evidence of going to Soul Food Cafe on the Ormo Road for lunch on the afternoon of June 28, 2016, a few hours after the alleged attack. Rory Harrison said he arrived there at approximately 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and the court heard he'd received a text from the complainant just over an hour beforehand to say what happened last night was not consensual. He said he was initially shocked when he read it, but after giving it some thought, he didn't believe her and decided not to tell Paddy about it because he didn't want to worry him about something he had no faith in being true. He denied discussing the text over lunch with his friends and denied discussing the fact she was upset in the taxi they shared home together. Ravenhill Road filling station is just a short walk from Paddy Jackson's home. A taxi driver called Stephen Fisher told the trial he parked up in the forecourt in the early hours of June 28, 2016, when he received a phone call from his control room to pick up a fare from the garage under the name of Harrison. Rory Harrison and the complainant got into the back of his taxi, and he told the jury she definitely seemed very upset and was crying or sobbing throughout. He said the man was attempting to comfort her by holding on to her. Mr. Fisher also spoke about Mr. Harrison being on the phone during the journey back to the complainant's house. He said he was talking in code and remembered him saying, "She's with me now. She's not good. I'll call you in the morning."